So welcome to the session. Let me continue with that last session. That last session we discussed about the metals, how the appearance and how the hardness and history of metals. Let me continue with that. The cobalt, the symbol for cobalt is CO. So it introduced at the year 1735, and the symbol for nickel is Ni. So introduced at the year 1751, and the symbol for manganese is Mn. It's introduced at the year 1774, and the symbol for tungsten is W. It introduced at the year 1783, and the symbol for uranium is U. It introduced at the year 1789, and titanium is introduced at the year 1791. The symbol for titanium is Ti, and beryllium. So beryllium formula is Be. So it introduced at the year 1797, and chromium it introduced at the year 1797. The symbol for chromium is Cr, and potassium, sodium, both are introduced at the year 1807. The symbol for potassium is K, and the symbol for sodium is Na. And boron, barium, calcium, magnesium, strontium. So these metals are introduced at the year 1808. So the boron, the symbol is B, and for barium the symbol is Ba, and for calcium the symbol is Ca, and for magnesium the symbol is Mg, and for strontium the symbol is Sr. And lithium, cadmium, selenium. So these three metals are introduced at the year 1817. So the symbol for lithium is Li, and for cadmium is Cd, and for selenium is Se. And aluminium. So aluminium is introduced at the year 1827. So the symbol for aluminium is Al. Let me see some common metals. So you can see here the gold. So what is the symbol for gold, children? Au. So the gold, so it's having the lustrous property and it's very hardness. So this gold, it can be used in various ornaments. So jewels. So this gold is having the various properties, and mainly it is used for the purpose of ornaments. Next is silver. The silver formula is Ag. So you can see here the silver, it's lustrous and very hard. So this silver, it can be used for making ornaments, vessels. And copper. So this copper, so what is the symbol for copper, children? Cu. So the copper, it can be used for making alloys. For example, so this copper is used in silver coins, gold coins. With that gold, the copper is there. In silver, copper is there. So the term alloy means the mixing of two or more metals is known as alloys. It will increase the hardness. It will increase the density. So that's why the copper is used in various alloys. And zinc. The symbol for zinc is Zn. So it's also lustrous and very hardness. And aluminium. So what is the symbol for aluminium, children? Al. So you can see here, the aluminium is shiny, it's lustrous and it's very hard. And next is iron. So what is the symbol for iron? Fe. So you can see the iron, it's shiny. So it's a lustrous property and it's very hard. And next is sodium. So the symbol for sodium is Na. So it's also having the lustrous property and it's also very hard. And magnesium. So you can see here the magnesium, it's having the shining property, that is lustrous is there. And it's very hard. And potassium. So what is the symbol for potassium? K. So you can see the potassium, it's having the lustrous property and it's very hard. And calcium. So calcium, it's also see lustrous shining will be there, and the calcium, it's very hard. And cobalt. So what is the symbol for cobalt, children? CO. So it's also having the lustrous property and it's very hard. And nickel. So what is the symbol for nickel? Ni. So it's also having the lustrous property and it's very hard. And water metals. So metals are minerals or substance. So metals are minerals or substance that form naturally below the surface of the earth. So the metals are minerals or substance that is naturally formed below from the surface of the earth. And the most metals are having the lustrous or shiny. And metals are inorganic. So inorganic means, so in the periodic table there are some elements are there. So in that, most of the elements we can tell it as inorganic. Inorganic means metals, which means they are made up of substance that are never alive. And metals are natural compounds of earth crust, in which they are generally found in the form of metal ores associated both with each other and with many other elements. So actually the metals which is obtained in the earth crust, so in the earth crust there are some metals which is associated with the form of ore. So with that ore we have to extract. Extract means we have to separate the metals. And so they are also naturally present in the rocks washed by the surface water and groundwater and in atmospheric dust. So these metals are naturally found in rocks by the surface water and groundwater and atmospheric dust. So from that the metals can be obtained. And these metals, substance which are electropositive in nature. So electropositive in nature. So electropositive in nature means it's having positive charge. That is known as electropositive charge. They have tendency to lose electrons. It So actually the metals having the electropositive in nature, and also in that electropositive means it's having the positive charge is there. So that positive charge, they have the tendency to lose electrons. For example, sodium, you can see what is the symbol for sodium? Na. The valency for sodium is +1, so we can tell it as Na plus. So if we write Na plus, Na plus means it will lose one electrons. For example, Fe. So Fe means iron. Fe3 plus means it will lose 3 electrons in iron. And copper, so Cu. In copper, the valency for copper, it will be 2 plus. So it will lose 2 electrons. So the metals which having the electropositive character. Electropositive character means it's having the tendency to lose electrons. For example, you can see the sodium. So sodium, its atomic number is 11. Sodium, its atomic number is 11, no? So it will lose one electron means, so how many electrons in Na plus? Yes, it's 10. It's lost one electron. And Fe3 plus and Cu2 plus in that same way. So the metals are having the electropositive character. Electropositive character means it will lose the electrons. Okay, children. So see you on next session. Thank you.